A very good morning, children. Today we will learn a very, very, very important chapter. Yes, this chapter you have learned in your previous classes. In your every classes, you learn this chapter, that is safety and first aid. But why do we teach you safety and first aid all the time? Are you careful all the time? Really? No. Somewhere, somewhat, we remain careless. We become careless, and because of these careless, accidents happen. Children, accidents can happen at any time, anywhere, without giving you any signal, without giving you any warning. Knowingly, unknowingly, accidents can happen suddenly. And as accidents happen suddenly, without our knowledge, we become hurt. Sometimes these accidents can unfortunately lead to death. And you also know, children, because of these accidents, it can be a minor accident or it can be a major accident. So children, today I request you all, once again, I know it's a very common chapter for you, but please, I request you, go through this video and from today only, try to follow the safety rules. You all are very grown up. You used to handle scissor, then knife, blade, paper cutter, and you think that nothing will happen to you. You will not cut your hand. But children, sharp objects are after all sharp objects. They are not toys. They are not any plaything that you will play. So be very careful while handling with scissor, while using scissor, while using knife. And if you are using such things, then either be very careful or use it in front of any adult. Otherwise, I would suggest don't use, try to be first you become a grown up and then you can use such kind of sharp objects. But as you are a child, so be very careful. Because if you will become careless, then you will cut your hand. Sharp objects will definitely cut your hand. And the cut can be deep. And once the cut can be deep, it can lead to many serious injury. You can undergo through operation. So the first thing is, while handling sharp objects, learn to use it correctly. And use them only under the guidance of an adult. Okay? Next thing is your electricity. We all have electricity in our house. And we do very small careless mistakes. Like after washing our hands, in our wet hands, we used to switch on or switch off and we used to play with the electrical appliances. We know that handling this with wet hands can definitely cause us an electric shock. And do you know? That electric shock can lead to death. It will just give you a severe shock and the person will die. It's not a minor shock. So electricity is, yes, it is useful, but it needs to be handled carefully. Sometimes somewhere, if the wire is loose or if any socket is loose, Or if the electric board is not in a proper condition, then no need to go near that. Just stay away that. No need to play near that. No need to stand near that. No need to stand near under the poles, under the big wires. No need to do that. Because you never know any time of any small mistake, the electric wire can get a shock. And those shock will automatically affect you if you are standing near that electrical appliances. And these shocks can become very dangerous and yes, it can lead to death. A person can die if he or she will undergo any electric shock. Next is your fire. We all love to play with crackers. We all enjoy Diwali. Sometimes we act like a hero by playing a matchstick. But my dear children, playing with a matchstick or playing with a firecracker will not show your heroism. Rather, being careful is shows you the real hero. that is a good boy, obedient boy, good student. So, don't become hero. Rather, if you want to become a real hero, then use it carefully. While playing with crackers, while handling matchsticks also, be very careful. Or if you feel like that you cannot do that, then doesn't matter. Let your parents handle, okay? Because mostly accidents happen when people are careless or when we are in a fun activity. And you also know every year in Diwali, accidents also happen because we just forget everything in the festive mood. And as we forget everything in the festive mood, we are in a, such an enjoyable manner. We have forgotten everything. We forgot to take the precautions while handling the firecrackers. And as we do this, accidents happen. So be very careful when lightening the crackers. And if you are handling the matchsticks also, be very careful. It's a not thing to play. Mark my words, these are not a thing to play. These are not your toys. Another one is your on the road. Everyone, we used to come on the road, we cross the road, we walk on the road, isn't it? But at the same time, we need to follow the traffic rules. Yes, children? Almost all the accidents happen on the road only. But why it happen? Either the people are driving recklessly or carelessly, or the person is not walking in the correct footpath. Rather, the person is walking in the middle of the road. So children, if you will follow the traffic rules and if you will walk on the footpath at the side of the road, along the side of the road, instead of walking in the middle of the road, then somewhat, to some extent, you are following the safety rules. And on the road, it is not a playground. It is a place to walk carefully, drive carefully, and anytime, any moment, the vehicle can come and it will smash you. Accidents can happen. So be very careful on the road. Always cross the road at the zebra crossing. And just follow the traffic signal. Okay? At what time you have to go? When the signal is red, you have to stop. When it is green, you can walk. And when it is orange, you have to wait for the other's turn. You should not be in a hurry mood while you are on the road. Okay, while you are crossing the road or while you are walking on the road, be very careful. Anytime, any moment, the vehicle can come and it can hit you. It can hit your hand, it can hit your legs. Any place it can hit you because the vehicle is in a very fast manner. Okay? Now children, safety begins from your home. At your home also, you need to be safe. You children, I have heard many complaints that you all are fighting with your younger brother and sister as if you are fighting with an animal. Children, in your fighting, any accident can take place. You are running, you are jumping, you are climbing here and there, on the table, under the chair, and in the entire house. Anytime you can slip, anytime the table and chair can hurt you, it can affect you. Climbing on the furnitures, running entire on the house, even in the school also. When the break time is there, when the bell rings, everyone just run to wash their hands. No children, you will not get a prize for that. You are not going to get an award for that. Rather, you are yourself hurting, okay? And you are yourself inviting the accident because you are careless. You are in a fun manner, you want to fight with your brother, you want to run and climb here and there, you want to behave like monkeys. But my dear children, ultimately at the end, you are going to hurt yourself and you don't know, you never know how extreme that accident can happen. And you might have seen in your school also, because of your carelessness, many of our school students sometimes, some have cut their head, hit their legs. Then our peon will be peon auntie and mousy auntie. They will be just rubbing the ice on your head or they will be applying any ointment. That is a very minor, but it can lead to major. So my dear children, inside the home also, instead of running, pushing, fighting, climbing, don't do that. Just stop it. It can be solved in a different manner instead of running and fighting. Okay? Another thing is your medicines. You are very small children. You don't know which medicine is good for you. Then it's better that just eat or take any medicines, asking your parents or asking the doctor. Never eat or drink anything which you are not at all sure of it. You don't know whether it is good or bad for you. If your friend or if any stranger is offering you, chal ye kha le, kuch nahi hoga, tu theek ho jayegi. No, never, never ever do that. Okay? Don't do that. Only ask your parents. Your parents will definitely give you correct advice. And obviously, doctor is always to help you, always there to help you. Okay, so eating all these wrong medicines or taking any kind of drinks or eating some unwanted medicines or in a form of chocolate, you will be feeling like it is a chocolate but is actually a medicine. Nowadays many medicines are in the form of chocolate, but it is actually a medicine. So eat, just be very careful, and if you are not sure, don't do that. Don't eat at all. Just ask your mother, ask your father, take advice from them, and then you can eat that medicines. Okay? And if you are having any younger brother and sister, then it is your duty, being an elder brother and sister, it is your responsibility to keep that medicines away from your small children. Okay? Last but not the least, swimming. Many of you know swimming. I know. It's a good thing that you know swimming. But children, having fun in the swimming pool is not good. If you know swimming, it's good. But always swim. Sometimes somewhat, you never know, your leg can slip or you can get faint inside the water. So it's better if you are swimming, just swim in front of any adult, or if your coach is over there, then just swim. And if you do not know swimming at all, then no need to go to the swimming pool alone and no need to go to the depth of the water. No need to go in the deep water. Okay? Because you can get drowned. Doob jaoge. Drowning means doob jana. Pani mein doob jaoge. And many children, you might have seen in news, they drown because of having fun in the water. Pani mein kya mazak? Pani ke saath kya mazak karna? Pani to mazak nahi karega. Pani le jayega andar. Okay? So, these are the small safety rules which can become major if we will not be careful. Okay? I hope you liked my video and I hope you will remember what your foreign miss said to you. My good children. Thank you, children.